Let's practice our 8 1/4 note triplets on our open E string. This is a short 2-measure exercise in 4/4. In measure 1, you see that we have 4 groups of 8th note triplets. And in measure 2, there are 2 groups of quarter note triplets. When we're all done, here's what it'll sound like. 1, 2, 3, and a 4, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, and a 3, and a. So let's get to it. In measure 1, we have 8th note triplets on our open E. Let's try just measure 1 2 times. Here are 8th note triplets. 1, 2, 3, and a 4, and a 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great. Now in measure 2, we have quarter note triplets on our open E string. Let's try just that measure together on open E 2 times. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and a 3 and a 1 and a 3 and a. Awesome. Now let's put the whole exercise together 4 times. Here we go on open E. I'll count you in. 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a Awesome. Triplets can be super tricky, especially quarter note triplets. So the best way to get a grasp on them is to go listen to them in real music. Check out a slow blues like Something by B.B. King, and you'll hear them all over the place. Great reading, and I'll see you next time. Let's practice our 8 1/4 note triplets on our open E string. This is a short 2-measure exercise in 4/4. In measure 1, you see that we have 4 groups of 8th note triplets. And in measure 2, there are 2 groups of quarter note triplets. When we're all done, here's what it'll sound like. 1, 2, 3, and a 4, and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1, and a 3, and a So let's get to it. In measure 1, we have 8th note triplets on our open E. Let's try just measure 1 2 times. Here are 8th note triplets. 1, 2, 3, and a 4, and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1, 2, 3, 4 Great. Now in measure 2, we have quarter note triplets on our open E string. Let's try just that measure together on open E 2 times. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1 and a 3 and a Awesome. Now let's put the whole exercise together 4 times. Here we go on open E. I'll count you in. 1, 2, 3 and a 4 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1, 2, 3, 4 1 and a 3 and a 1, 2, 3 Triplets can be super tricky, especially quarter note triplets. So the best way to get a grasp on them is to go listen to them in real music. Check out a slow blues like Something by B.B. King, and you'll hear them all over the place. Great reading, and I'll see you next time.
Here's the riff to Move On Up by Curtis Mayfield. This bass line is repeated throughout the entire song, and it sounds like this. Now let's take a look at the fret head. The chord progression we are following along to is F sharp minor, E minor, A, and B minor. We'll separate the riff into four separate sections to help with memorization. Let's focus on the fret locations and the fingers to use first. Now, section one, we're just going to start off with our fourth finger on the ninth fret of the A string, which is the F sharp. Then we're going to go to E, which is the seventh fret of the A string with our first finger. And it sounds like this. Now, section two, we're going to slide up from the ninth fret of the G string to the 11th fret of the G string with our fourth finger. And then we're going to go back down and play the ninth fret of the G string with our fourth finger again, and then the ninth fret of the D string with our fourth finger, and end it off with our first finger on the seventh fret of the A string, playing an E. Now, section three, we're going to play with our fourth finger the ninth fret of the A string. Then we're going to go with our first finger to the seventh fret of the D string. And then we're going to play the ninth fret of the D string with our fourth finger. It should sound like this. Now in section four, we're going to start with our fourth finger on the ninth fret of the D string, like this. Then we're going to use that same fourth finger and play the seventh fret of the D string, like this. And then we're going to use our first finger to play the fourth fret of the D string. And then we're going to go to the fifth fret of the A string with our second finger. Should sound like this. When comfortable, try adding some slides. You can slide every time into the high F sharp. And let's throw in some vibrato on the B note, like this. Let's look at the whole riff from another angle. Now let's take a look at the rhythm. We're going to be focusing on alternating our index and middle finger, like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Let's take a closer look at that rhythm hand. Now let's try playing the notes together. Don't worry about adding the slides and vibrato until you're comfortable with the notes and rhythm. We'll play through it two times. I'll count you in. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and 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 second time. End it right here. And that gets us to the main riff. Here's the riff to Move On Up by Curtis Mayfield. This bass line is repeated throughout the entire song, and it sounds like this. Now let's take a look at the fret head. The chord progression we are following along to is F sharp minor, E minor, A, and B minor. We'll separate the riff into four separate sections to help with memorization. Let's focus on the fret locations and the fingers to use first. Now, section one, we're just going to start off with our fourth finger on the ninth fret of the A string, which is the F sharp. Then we're going to go to E, which is the seventh fret of the A string with our first finger. And it sounds like this. Now, section two, we're going to slide up from the ninth fret of the G string to the 11th fret of the G string with our fourth finger. And then we're going to go back down and play the the ninth fret of the G string with our fourth finger again, and then the ninth fret of the D string with our fourth finger, and end it off with our first finger on the seventh fret of the A string playing an E. Now, section three, we're going to play with our fourth finger, the ninth fret of the A string. Then we're going to go with our first finger to the seventh fret of the D string. And then we're going to play the ninth fret of the D string with our fourth finger. It should sound like this. Now, in section four, we're going to start with our fourth finger on the ninth fret of the D string, like this. Then we're going to use that same fourth finger and play the seventh fret of the D string, like this. And then we're going to use our first finger to play the fourth fret of the D string. And then we're going to go to the fifth fret of the A string with our second finger. It should sound like this. When comfortable, try adding some slides. You can slide every time into that high F sharp. And let's throw in some vibrato on the B note, like this. Let's look at the whole riff at another angle. Now let's take a look at the rhythm hand. We're going to be focusing on alternating our index and middle finger, like this. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and. Let's take a closer look at that rhythm hand. Now let's try playing the riff together. Don't worry about adding the slides and vibrato until you're comfortable with the notes and rhythm. We'll play through it two times. I'll count you in. One, two, three, four. One and two and three and four and 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 second time. End it right here. And that gets us to the main riff. Thank you.